Beverly Jenny in court is a startling sight. Even more so to know she's accused of murdering one woman and trying to kill another. But let's start from the beginning. On December 19th, police arrived to a brutal and complex crime scene. One woman dead, another shot, an 85-year-old Beverly Jenny with a cord around her neck, and a note that said she was, quote, driven to this, according to court documents. Investigators didn't know at first who was a suspect and who was a victim, but ultimately Jenny was charged with the crime. Documents say she once owned the Federal Way home, but eventually lost it to the bank. When sisters Janet and Angela Owega, who are from Kenya, moved into the home, friends tell us they weren't expecting Jenny to be there. But because of their cultural respect for elders, they allowed her to stay a little longer until she found a place to live. Going off the note investigators believe Jenny wrote before they say she attempted to kill herself, she didn't have a plan, saying, quote, I'm 85 and have no place to go. What happened next also horrified neighbors. Less than a week after Jenny was charged with murder, the Federal Way home at the center of the case went up in flames, destroying everything surviving sister Angela owned. Adding to the mystery, the cause of the fire is still undetermined. The sister's grieving father told me by phone from Kenya that the fire is another puzzling and heartbreaking piece of this nightmare.
Extremely shocked, confused, and disturbed. I don't think there can be any justice. All I want is my daughter's body back here.
Loved ones are currently trying to raise funds to send Janet's body back to Kenya for burial. Meanwhile, Beverly Jenny is facing legal woes for the first time in her life. The 85-year-old moved slowly in the courtroom using a walker, her attorneys towering over her.
081-763-KNT. Is your true and correct name Beverly Lorraine Jenny?
Yes.
Jenny's voice sounds as frail as she looks, a stark contrast to the gruesome, premeditated crime she's accused of committing. Today, her attorneys entered in a plea of not guilty, the very beginning stages of what could be a long legal saga. Olivia LaVoice, Q13 News.
If you'd like to help Janet and Angela's family,